it up.
Yeah, I gotta get a few tools going.
How long does it take you to do one of those?
To do a leaf?
Well, I'll show ya.
No, about 20 minutes just to do one with a little bit less detail. That just creates the bud, so you're kind of just like sculpting volume first. So just kind of like in nature, you just the leaf starts as a bud first and then kind of opens up. So
yeah.
Next I just come over and I just sharpen the tip a little bit, just on the end of my hand. Squish straight down and that gives the basic shape.
Wow.
Put in. Then so end up putting in sort of like a little vein texture, just with like a sharp hammer peen here. I have a tool for under the power hammer that sort of gives it a bit of texture, but it looks nicer when it's done by hand and it's a little more randomized. A bit of natural texture.
Yeah.
At least for certain kinds of leaves anyway. End up putting a sort of a chiseled in vein down the center like on those other leaves, and
yeah.
You know, in nature it's a raised vein, but just using a chisel just sort of gives you the idea like that it's there, and you let your imagination kind of do the real fine detail. Gives the impression that there's something there anyway.
Oh yeah.
Then just end up separating sort of the leaf from the main parent material. And so there's tons of ways to cut the material. I mean, bandsaw, torches, plasma cutter, abrasive discs, but you know, historically, if it's hot, you have something sharp and a hammer, then you can cut it. You just do it slowly. I have lots of time to sort of work through it slow. It doesn't go flying. You just do it really controlled. Because if you were to hammer right through the piece, then you'd wreck this tool and you'd wreck your hammer face as well. So you just kind of want to be careful. Thank you. So it's kind of neat just how the different heats of the hammers all sort of accomplish different things. Just the crossbeam, the way someone described it that was memorable and simple and kind of comical as well was, you think of a fresh cow poop, and if you were to sort of come up to the cow poop and jump and stomp on it with 2 feet, then basically it would spray in all directions, which is sort of relating to sort of that type of a hammer anyway, is that it moves in all directions. But if you were to come up to that fresh cow poop and stomp on it with 1 foot, then it would spray in one axis just across this way. So that's sort of what this type of hammer accomplishes, just moving the metal this way and that. And then so to sort of concentrate the force anyway, you end up using sort of, you know, a peen like this over the horn of the anvil, kind of accomplishes the same thing, just moves the material in this axis. So it's neat as I hammer out the stem. Once it starts to cool down, you can actually see the hammer blows introduce heat back into it, just because the molecules are like, there's so much friction as they're moving, if you hammer in the right sequence, that actually puts the heat back into the material. So ultimately it's gonna be sort of a rough round shape, but you have to work in a square to change the cross section before you can turn it into something round. So square to octagon, you break the corners again, you start to get something that's kind of resembles round. Spend the time to put the texture into the leaf and everything, and you end up using sort of wooden stumps and wooden mallets. This is like rawhide, so that you can still sort of move the material, but you don't sort of mar the texture right. That you put in. The next step being the one that makes it the most realistic, just giving it a little bit of curvature on the leaf. It looks right. Like it's sort of natural and wind blown. Once it's cleaned up, I find that goes a long way into making it look realistic.
Yeah.
Just turn the stem into a little sort of socket. Turns into like a keychain or something.
Right.
Then after I clean it up with the wire wheel, and sort of it looks pretty.
All right.
Yeah.